Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Miss Nekopan. Today we're going to talk about how to make criminia. Criminia is a super helpful ingot that you will use to make armor, weapons, and all kinds of other things. I want to thank you, my viewers, Elizabeth and Zach, for submitting this question. If you have any questions on something that I might be able to help with, let me know in the comments down below and I might be able to make a video about it. And with that, let's get started. In order to make criminia, you actually need to know how to make stardium first. If you don't know how to make stardium, I have a video that I made before, and I can link it to you here and in the description box below. So to start, let's make sure you have the right things unlocked in your skill tree. Let's make sure you have ingot, which is 2 right from the beginning. And you'll also want morph, which is 1 down from the beginning. Morph is really important so that you can upgrade your basic recipes into advanced ones. Now let's check on the recipe for criminia. If you have made stardium before, you'll know that you need ingot to make stardium, which you will see at the bottom here. And then with stardium, you can morph into the criminia recipe. Looking at the stardium recipe now, it looks like we will need more arknights, sand, gases, and then degenesis stone to make criminia. Now, this degenesis stone is something you can get from the ancient mana workshop with an axe. If you don't have this location unlocked yet, you cannot make criminia. Let's head out to the world map and go to the ancient mana workshop and check out Fire People's Village. Make sure to bring an axe with you. From the start, keep running down the path on the left side, and eventually you will hit a river. Once you hit the river, go ahead and jump straight into it. Swim up the river path until you find a glowing purple rock. It's pretty large and glowy, so I don't think you're gonna miss it. With an axe, you can cut into the glowing purple rock where you will reveal getting river stones and also degenesis stones. Let's grab a few more while we're here. Start by crawling through the hole in the wall over here. Once you enter, you'll see there's one on the roof here and one on the right side of the path uphill over here and one behind you. So in total, there are 4 glowy rocks that you can smack to get some more degenesis stones. There are several places you can find these glowy purple rocks throughout the ancient mana workshop, but these 4 will do for now. Let's go back to the Tillier now and see what we can make with all this. I'm going to start by selecting the stardium recipe. Let's fill out all the circle nodes, which are the required ones in order to make stardium. Checking the first optional hexagonal node on the right side, you'll see that we need 5 fire elements to unlock it. So let's make sure to put in 5 values of fire in the arknight node. You can see the element value at the bottom of the icon and the element at the top of it. Let's continue to put items into the node path to the right until we get to the last node, which is the one that unlocks the criminia recipe. Here it says you need degenesis stones and also 3 wind elements, so let's put those in there. Again, you can see the element values at the bottom and the element on top of the icons. Degenesis stones usually have 2 to 3 ice and wind element values. After putting in the required ingredients, you can now see the stardium recipe has morphed into a criminia recipe. Execute the synthesis now to learn it and add criminia to your recipe list. Now you should see criminia in your recipe list like this, and you don't have to start over at the stardium or ingot level again to make criminia. You can just enter the recipe straight from here and you'll notice there's a pattern for upgrading ingot recipes. Just like how ingot morphs into stardium and stardium morphs into criminia, you'll see the next ingot upgrade is also on this recipe node that requires golden knights. Anyway, that's it for this tutorial. Thank you so much for watching and I hope this was helpful to you. If you have any questions or content ideas, let me know. Please like, comment, and subscribe for more Atelier content in the future. See you next time. Bye!